greatest hockey player who ever lived. I thought I'd just put that on there tonight.
You have a stat about him, but we'll save it for another day. You're looking good as Michel Therrien.
Looking? Are you going to show them walking
in?
No, we got no time. All right, but they look good walking in. All right, let's go.
Up 1-0 lead for the Canadians
now,
in Florida, Toronto, Detroit. Last night first.
Last night, absolute linesman. Should never have happened. Poor, now, if you drop the puck, there's no problem. I know he hit his hand. Poor Dion goes in. He doesn't know. I mean, he hadn't taken one right off the bat. That could cost them the playoffs, although they're playing good tonight. Now, they kicked out MacLean. Now, watch tonight. They let in, take it, and watch what happens. And I'm going to show you. Now, let it go. Let it go. Now, watch. Now, hold it right there if you can. The left winger in my team would have went to the left point or the right point, right? You got that. I don't like to get technical, but all right. Go ahead.
Do you think? Well, hold it. Do you think it's because Brody has the right winger tied up?
You'll never get it through. We'll show it again. Yeah. You see what happens? Do is show it again. Look here. What he should have done, the left winger, go to the point. There's no problem. What happens is the other guy looks up. He can't see anything. See? Not getting through there. So this guy goes here, over there, in the net. Hey, that's why the Boston Bruins four first place finishes all the time, because we had the points covered. And you're asking why there's so many goals from the point, because the dum-dums, as you say, collapse, and that's what happened. All right, let's go.
On the Gustav Nyquist forecheck that Glenn thought it was good, he's read off Franzen and goes in on Gunnarsson. But
worst I've ever seen, because it's Detroit. Let's see it right now. And you got Nyquist coming in. He looks back. Watch what happens. Let's hear. Look at that. Is that a soft hockey or what? Watch Lusick. You play the Boston Bruins, this is what happens. Look, this guy's terrified. He lets him get the puck and put it out. That's why the Boston Bruins never lose. They lose to guys like that. You're going to take a guy. You're going to take a guy. We're going to show. We won't even show.
Sure we can. Paul Ranger, if you want.
Watch this,
is what happened here.
Turn it back when you get against a guy that really hits somebody.
Kilhorn, Tampa.
Watch this here. Lucky turns back. This is the way the guy should be taken. Unfortunately, he got hurt. But that's, if you're going to play hockey, that's the way it is, like this. And Lusick and the St. Louis, there's no prisoners taken when you go in the corner. That's why Detroit doesn't, nobody's afraid of Detroit. I hate to tell you. I know you're watching up there, but nobody's afraid. Go ahead.
Who's watching up there?
Well, you know.
Oh, the Red Wings?
Draper and Holland and all those guys.
Okay.
I mean, they got all the... Well, we won't go into that. Go ahead.
Listen, you mentioned the other day that you had Jerry Cheevers and you had Gilles Gilbert, two number one goaltenders.
This is terrific.
Yeah.
I said, just a minute, what I said was I used to protect Cheevers all the time, and I used to put Gilbert... When I was going into, say, Philly or someplace like that, and I thought, I'm going to save... Cheevers for maybe Pittsburgh or something, I'd throw in Gilly and I'd say, if we win, hey, we win, we don't hurt Cheevers. Now, the other night, Therrien goes, he's got Buffalo after he plays Boston. Boston's won 13 in a row. They never lose at home. I'll throw in Budaj. Watch, and he said, if he wins, hey, if he doesn't win, if he gets murdered, I don't hurt my number one goalie. Budaj, he comes in, plays, and Budaj knows, eh? Everybody knows why he's a sacrificial lamb. Just what Michel thought. He stood on his head, and they win the game 2-1. The next night, he puts in Price against Buffalo, not knocking Buffalo, but Buffalo wins 2-0. That's smart thinking. You people just don't understand. You know why you don't understand? Because you haven't been there. I have.
You had Bobby. I was telling you about a goal last Sunday that you loved.
I tell you, Travis, what is it?
Hamonic.
Watch this, Bobby Orr right here. We put it in right here. Watch this. Is this beautiful? This is what Bobby used to do. And you know, that's a big goal, eh? That just might put Leafs in the playoffs, which we're all trying for.
Hey, well, you are. You might want to look for the guys upstairs on that one. Columbus Blue Jackets threw the Islanders beat on that one 2-0. So yeah. The Nets, Don, this is a little thing you've...
You know, when I hate to interrupt, but I don't have much time, eh? But here's the thing. Watch this here. I said at one time, when they cut the back of the net off that 6 inches, it's going to get top heavy. And they said, oh, how silly can you be saying something like that? And look what happened. It's top heavy. You hardly touch it. When they have these meetings with the safety, they said, well, listen, we got to get to the golf. The golf course is coming. Let's see. What do you say? All right. You like to cut the... All right. Harump. If they had me there, I would have told them they would have been top heavy. And you got to protect your goalie better than that.
Spencer McFadden.
Oh, we got to get... Okay. We have this young boy, Spencer. We have him here. He's going to Orangeville. He's a lovely boy. He's only 6 years old, and he's playing for Orangeville. And God love his father, David, and Sharon, his mom and dad, and his sisters and that. And he got head-on crash. And he's a hockey guy. He used to be playing out in the laneway. Our hearts go out to you. And I don't know what else to say. God love you. And we'll be joining you someday. That's the only thing I can say. Mm. And now we have good news anyhow after that is Constable, Mike Clarenbeck. I mean, this guy is a hero of heroes. There's a guy, if you don't know what happened, there's a guy with a gun got through security. They had moms upstairs. They had all the kids upstairs. There's 100 people in there. And this guy got in with a gun. And Mike went after him and told him to stop. And the guy shot him. And they took care of that guy. I don't want to say anything else than that. But guys, you know, whatever the police are getting, you see something like that, he's in Sunnybrook and in the whole deal, whatever money they're making, as anybody says, they're making too much money, and you see something like that, how could they say that? Mike, you're a great guy. The police, Division 22 appeal, you're great guys. You're the best.
We're with you tonight on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.